In this video I'd like to show you how to create linear scans using Nikon Scan. What that means is that we are going to configure Nikon Scan so that it won't perform any image editing at all and will save the data it gets from the scanner straight into a TIFF file. I am currently running Nikon Scan on macOS X Snow Leopard, which was the last version where Nikon Scan for OS X could be used, because the Nikon Scan software was authored for the old PowerPC platform and Snow Leopard was the final version of OS X to support that via emulation. On Windows computers, Nikon Scan can still be used on all versions, although to use it on 64-bit Windows, you will have to use a special technique we detail on our webpage on using Nikon Scan for ColorPerfect. To get started with creating linear scans, we first have to change a couple of preferences, so we choose Nikon Scan Preferences. What we'd like to do is setting the gamma from 1.8 on the Mac or 2.2 on Windows computers to 1. In order to be able to do so, we first need to disable the Nikon color management system. Changing back to the gamma tab, we find that gamma is now editable and that we can set this to 1. If you are not using a fresh installation of Nikon Scan, we should also take a look at the Advanced Color tab. Please make sure that the white point targets are all set to 255, the gray point targets are set to 127, and the black point targets are set to 0. After having set this up, OK out of the preferences, and note that we will have to restart the Nikon Scan software. So let's exit Nikon Scan and restart it. Alright. Once the general preferences are set, it is important that we choose positive for our scan because we don't want Nikon Scan to invert our image, as we intend to do that using ColorPerfect's ColorNet mode later on. So next, let's discuss the various settings on the tool palette. On the Crop tab, we can set up the desired resolution. When scanning for archival purposes, it is usually best to set this to the maximum optical resolution the scanner is capable of. For the modern Nikon scanners, this will usually be 4000 dpi. Next, we can disable the Curves tab, the Color Balance tab, the Unsharp Mask tab, and the LCH Editor tab, if they were accessible. On the Digital ICE 4 tab, we can enable the automated removal of dust and scratches. Whether this is best set to normal or fine depends on your image, but we have found that we like normal better more often than not. Do not enable any of the post-processing options, ROC or GEM, and also do not enable digital DEE. Next, it's important to set the scanner bit depth to either 16 bits per channel for the latest generation of Nikon scanners or to 14 bits per channel for the previous generation of Nikon scanners. If you like, you can also set up multi-sampling. For this tutorial video, I'll stay at normal mode. When using a Nikon CoolScan LS8000, be sure to enable the Superfine Scan feature, because there was a problem with the stepping motors in that scanner, which produced banding effects in the darkest parts of a scan, which in case of negative scans correlate to much brighter areas after the inversion, so the effect will be much more visible and usually disturbing. When scanning color negatives, it is also generally permissible to use analog gains to eliminate the orange mask and to increase per channel detail. For scanners with an actual 16-bit analog-digital converter, this is usually not required. For the previous generation of scanners, the quality increase was more noticeable. Still, I'm going to show you how to set that up. For color negatives, red is usually the brightest channel. The data recorded by the green channel is darker, so it should be fine if we used an exposure increase of 1 f-stop here. And it should even be fine to use about 2 f-stops of an exposure increase for the blue channel. Please note that enabling the analog gains We'll increase lamp brightness as long as that's possible, and after that we'll lengthen exposure time, which will effectively slow down your scan. For the modern scanners, what I'd recommend is finding out what values do not lengthen your scan time noticeably and to stick with those. I know that the frame I'm going to scan is at index 3. However, when switching to index 3, all my settings will be lost, as we did configure the frame at index 1. Let's go back to index 1 and save our settings. We choose Settings, Save Settings, and give the settings a descriptive name. Linear negative 1x for the multi-sampling, 1g, 2b for the analog gain settings. And let's confirm that by pressing OK. Now we can switch to index 3 and restore the settings we just saved from our settings list. Since I know that I did insert the film into the holder, there is no need for a preview scan, and I'll create the final scan right away. Since I did not configure the autosave feature in the options, we will now have to save our scan. Let's say, and let's save it on the desktop. Of course, you can also use Nikon Scan's batch scanning features when creating linear scans, which will usually automatically save your scans to disk. After having created the scan, we can now leave Nikon Scan.